basis of verification, as I already said. But as we are moving on, we're moving from one season to another, we find this day comes to end. And so we make this consideration because it's according to the work of the divine providence that here on and on,
you have a family
today. Not yesterday, not tomorrow. They come behind us today. And in this day, we're still in the celebration of the Epiphany. So on this day, you've ended something. You've ended your former single lives and have begun a life together with your income. And this means that before each of them had a separate responsibility before God. They were raised up in their families to them, but they had a separate responsibility before God to know Him, to love Him, and to serve Him in this life, so as to be happy with Him forever and ever. Very simple. Sometimes it pays to think of the simple things. Now, as of about 40 minutes ago, they've taken on a new responsibility. Together and separately, to know God, to love Him, to serve Him in this life, themselves and through each other, and to assist each other in that knowledge, love, and service of God. Soon we pray that God may bless them with others, with children. And so we ask also, we realize that in taking on this responsibility to know God, love Him, and serve Him together, they're also taking on, we pray, the responsibility to raise children to God, to know Him, love Him, and serve Him in this life, all of which is for the purpose of being with Him forever and ever. It's important to think of that at every point in our lives, at every point when there's a need for change. Now to one of the particulars of God's providence about choosing this day. In this time, in the time of the Epiphany, we actually celebrate three great mysteries in the life of the Church. The Church celebrates these three great mysteries because, according to the most ancient and attested traditions, these three events in the life of Christ happened on the same day in different years. The first of them, the one we normally think of, the coming of the Magi, the adoration of the Magi, of the child Jesus. The second is the baptism of Jesus in the Jordan by John. And the third is the wedding of Jesus. Two of these were mentioned in the prayers of the year. But all three come together on this day, and it seems fitting that a wedding should be celebrated in the midst of the celebration of these things. And I think it pays to think about this. A brief meditation on this. We take the first one, the adoration.
And we see a wonderful example
She's quiet. And she stands behind